Good morning, everybody. Happy Thursday, Esoteric Creation Challenge Day. I'm sitting up a little bit closer. I'm having the microphone issue here. So I do have a new mic. I ordered a new mic. But until then, I'm going to be up a little bit closer. I apologize if the last 2 days I realized that there were some issues with my mic. So just to be super cautious, I'm really up close, but I will go back for a full body shot for our Move It and Groove It. This is a Esoteric Creation Challenge Day. We do this every Thursday. Our theme today are all about medical genre, medical drama. So we'll do that. I'll get more to that and how the challenges are going to go this year. I'm really excited. But before we do that, you know what we had to do? We had to get warm up with some moving and grooving, okay? Good woman, good moving around. Like I said, I'm sitting a little bit closer. The next two classes because I'm having some issues with my microphone. So here we go. This year, as we do our Thursday character creation challenges, we are going to do it. Well, we're always going to imagine that we're have a role in a film or a TV show. I will always give you the genre. Today, we're doing the medical show, California Med. That's the name of the show. The made-up show, California Med. That's the name of the show. And you guys are playing co-stars in the show, okay? So what will happen is, you all lines are going to be improvised. Everything's going to be improvised. And this will also allow you to work on your improvisation skills. So we'll go to an image. Go to an image, and then I will explain what we're going to do. If you're imagining that you're reacting to something in this image, for example, the person that you're going to go to is an older man. He's sitting in a hospital waiting room, and he has he's leaning forward, his hands are on his head is on his hands, and he looks very worried or sad. Okay, that's the image. I will always describe the image. And then you are going to imagine that your imaginary circumstance is you are this person's son or daughter, and you're reassuring your dad that your mom, who's in surgery, is going to be okay. So let me give you an example of what I mean, and then we'll go to the full picture, and I'll go through it again, okay? Dad, I know you love me. I'm gonna be okay. No, she is. Okay. I'm gonna be fine. Okay, cool. So that will be improv, right? So again, I played the daughter. I imagine I'm looking at my dad, reassuring him that my mom is gonna be okay with her surgery. So that is our first one. We're gonna do four different scenes each time. I'll show you an image. I'll always describe what the image looks like for those of you who need that description. And then we'll go to three takes of each scene. So what I want you to imagine is you're on set, you've been cast in this role, and you're doing three takes as they're filming the scene. Okay, so a Thursday character creation are always gonna be like imagining as close as I can get to imagine that you're working on set. Okay, so again, the first image we're gonna go to is this one, and with the man, worried man in the waiting room. You play his daughter or son, you're reassuring your dad that everything's gonna be okay. So we'll go to the image, we'll try to get through it, we'll also do three takes of the scene, and we'll come back and do another one, okay? So let's go to the first image. Okay, guys, we have the first image. Again, the older man, he's sitting, has like faith in his hands, like he's doing a prayer, he's leaning forward, he's looking worried. You imagine that this is your dad. Your mom's in surgery, and you're reassuring your dad that your mom is gonna be okay. So on action, that's what it's gonna be. And I'm gonna give you an action, a take one, and then you just imagine that you're saying something to your dad to reassure him everything is gonna be okay. Okay, and action, take one. Good guys, very good. Let's do another one, ready? I'm at you, just talking to your dad, all right? We're doing this scene a second time. Ready, guys? You're reassuring your dad. What do you need to say to your dad so he won't worry, okay? Ready, and take two, and action. All right, good guys, good. And I know this might be challenging, but just imagine you're on set. You're working with this actor. You're doing the scene, okay? And let's do take three, ready? Take three, and action. Good, and cut. Good job, guys, good job.
All right, good game, good to shake that out. Guys, you can stand a bit if you want. Again, I'm sitting for the microphone. Let's shake that out. Good. Let's go to the second image, right? I'm gonna look at it here. You see a doctor. He's sitting down. Is it a young doctor, male doctor? He's sitting down. He's looking up. He looks upset. He's wearing blue gloves. He's sitting in a hospital hallway, and he's looking up, all right? I want you to imagine that the doctor is looking at you. You are the doctor's boss, the supervisor, all right? So the role of this role is the hospital administrator or supervisor. That's the person that runs the hospital. That's the role you're playing. The doctor's looking up at you. So again, imagine the doctor's looking up at you. You're standing over him. He's looking up at you. He looks very upset. All right.
and you are fighting him. All right? He's screwed up many times, and so you're firing him. So, again, when we go to the image, I'm going to direct you, you're going to imagine we're firing the stock trick. All right? That is your job. You're the supervisor. You're firing the stock trick. Okay? Let's go to the image. Okay, guys, here we are. We have the doctor. All right? So I want you to, when you do this one, think about what the statue did to screw up, okay? Because you're firing him right now, all right? So in your improv, in your imagination, when you're reacting and telling him he's fired, be specific about what he did. Did he, you know, was something bad to a patient? Use your imagination, all right? You are telling the doctor he's fired and why, okay? So that's the improv. He's looking up at you. And again, it's the doctor in scrubs, blue scrubs. He's looking up. He's sitting down on the floor in the hallway. He's looking up. And so imagine you're looking down on him. You're standing or, you know, you're up above him. Or if you either, You're above him. He is looking up at you, okay? So just imagine that. You are above him, standing up. Your wheelchair user, you're still above him, okay? All right, so we're going to go to action and take one. All right, this is firing supervisor. All right, take one. Action. Good, 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 and cut. We're gonna do it again. He's just looking at you. You have to fire him. Maybe it's, you know, think about deepen it. How hard is it for you to fire him? Really deepen this, okay? Let's do take two and action. Good, 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 very good. Let's do one more, okay? Cut. Take three. And action. Cut. Very good, guys. Very, very good.
Good, good. Let's shake that out. Okay, so we have two more scenes we're going to work on today. All right. Cool. Let's shake that out. All right, let's go to the third image. Very angry patient. We have a patient, a man, he's sitting in a hospital bed. He's really angry. He's holding on to his beeper, and he's really mad. It's like he's yelling. This very angry patient looks like he's yelling. He's yelling at you. He's been yelling in the hospital. Your character is a nurse. You're coming in. You're telling him to calm down. Then it's Peter. Peter's a patient. All right? So again, this very angry patient, he's yelling at you. He looks really angry. He has fits. He's yelling, and you're coming as the nurse. Your character, the nurse, to calm him down. Let's go to the image, and I'll direct you to that image, okay? Let's go to the full image.
Okay, guys, so we're at the full image. We have this, again, you're imagining, you're filming this scene. You have this actor playing the patient, Peter the patient. He was very angry. He had a gun in bed. He had one fist up on the paper, one fist up. He was really angry. Imagine he's been yelling in his hospital room, and you're coming into the hospital room to tell him to be quiet, all right? Maybe you were outside in the nurse's station, you hear him yelling, you come in, and you need to calm him down and tell him to be quiet. So your lines, you're reacting to him yelling, and you're trying to calm him down. That is the scene, okay? So ready?
angry patient, take one, and action. Good, good cut. So God is really using your imagination, right? Imagine you hear him yelling, all right? All right, and that's what you need to do sometimes for an audition. Imagine what your partner's saying, okay? So ready? Let's do angry patient, take two. Ready? Take angry patient, take two. And action! You hear the yelling. Come in and calm him down. Try. Good, 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 guys, good, guys. And let's do it one more time. We're doing take three. Remember, your job, you're trying to calm him down. Your character is the nurse. Ready? And angry, all right, angry patient, take three. And action! And cut! Good job, guys. You guys are doing so great. All right, cut.
Good, 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 good. Shake that out. Shake that out. Good, 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 good. Shake that out. Good. We're good to the final one. Okay? Again, I'll have it here. And then we'll go to the bigger image. All right. So here we have this really happy doctor. Right? He's smiling. He's an epic, young African-American doctor. Smiling glasses, really, really happy to be in a doctor. So she looks really, really excited. Okay? So you and this and your doctor too, she is your friend. You both applied to be head of pediatrics. Pediatric for the kid. So you're both pediatric doctors. You both applied for the job to be head of pediatrics. So you're telling you now, I got the job, I'm head of pediatrics. You try this. You need to congratulate her, but you're very disappointed. So you need to hide your disappointment. So let me try and give you a little bit of an example, then we'll go to he got the job. Awesome. Congratulations. I'm really happy for you. Again, something like that. Again, guys, we're doing this improv, right? This is not a right line. I'm just giving you the scenario. So let's go to the image.
Okay, guys, final one. This is your friend. We call her Sally. You both work in the hospital. You both applied to be the head of pediatrics. The pediatrics is the kids, right? All right, so she says, I got the job. I got the head of pediatrics. I am head of pediatrics. She's all excited. You are disappointed, but you need to congratulate her and hide your disappointment. Sorry about the thing. All right? Well, again, what does that feel like? You're realizing you didn't get the job, but you still need to congratulate her, even though you're very disappointed. We'll do three takes. Ready? Disappointment response, take one, and action. Good, good, guys, good. Let's do another one. You're doing take two. Remember, you have to answer and congratulate her and hide that disappointment. Ready? Disappointment, take two, and action. Good, you hear, I got it, I got it. You respond and you have that disappointment. So you're congratulating her but hiding that disappointment. Good, and cut. Sometimes I forget to say cut. All right, let's do one more. Disappointment, congratulations, take three, And action! And cut! Really good job, guys. Really good job.
Alright, Kim. Good, good, good. Shake it out. Shake it out. Good. Good, 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 good. So, let's go to our character creation challenge for today.
Yes!
Alright, guys. Our character creation challenge. We've done four different scenes. So you can see the videotape. I always prefer you videotape one. Alright, because we're doing our first showcase probably at the beginning of April, okay? So take one of these and send me the scene. So the scenarios are the comforting son or daughter, comforting your dad and telling your dad that your mom's gonna be okay with the surgery, because your mom's in surgery. So the first one is the comforting son or daughter. Okay, that's the first one you can do. The second choice you have is the supervisor fathering this young daughter. Young doctor, I apologize. The supervisor fathering this doctor. The third one you have is the nurse trying to calm down the angry patient. The fourth one is trying to hide your disappointment when your friend got the job as head of pediatrics. Right? So again, you record yourself. I know you might, you'll just record like your monologue, okay? Your reaction. Don't worry about the picture. You're just recording your reaction. Again, this will all come to you in your email tomorrow when I send out my weekly email. So you'll get that tomorrow. But that is your character creation challenge. I'm going to do the following Wednesday, which is Wednesday. Yeah, and my calendar.
Hey guys, looking at the calendar, it's due Wednesday, January 26th. January 26th.
Determine this character creation challenge. All right. So again, I've lived down by your character creation challenges, and it could be the son or daughter trying to comfort his or her worried father, the supervisor firing a doctor for screwing up, the nurse trying to calm an angry patient, or the friend trying to hide his or her your disappointment because their friend got the job as head of pediatrics. All right? So those are your character creation challenges for today. We're going to go to some more moving and grooving. I'll see you guys tomorrow. COVID in mind.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
Oh, yeah.
A singer in a smoke cave.